Hello and welcome to the Classical Guitar LPs podcast. I'm your host, Aaron Powell. For this episode, we will be listening to sides 3 and 4 of the very outstanding album, John Williams Plays Bach, The Complete Lute Music on Guitar. This is on the Columbia record label, M233510 from 1975. Sides 1 and 2 were on the previous episode, and if you haven't checked that already, I would encourage you to do so. It's a wonderful record. We'll be right back. If you're a regular listener to this program, you know that I often go back and sort of retrace the experiences that I had in my youth as a young guitar player and as a young student musician. It's sort of a nice trip for me to go down in terms of memory lane, and I guess it's sort of enjoyable for me to do that and to share that with this audience. One of the things that I knew going into my undergraduate career at Simpson College was that you could learn a lot by reading the information on record jackets or CD jackets or cassette liner notes, whatever the medium would be. My teachers and my instructors at Simpson made a huge deal about that. And anyone who may have been a music major would know about this practice. You were assigned a bunch of listening examples to learn. And back in my day, even though technologically we should have been using CDs, my teachers still used the drop the needle, and they would use the records and they would, you know, go into a Beethoven symphony and play like the second movement or the third movement that maybe you didn't know quite as well. And they would drop that needle and you'd have to know what that was, and you'd have these listening exams. And so anyway, it's sort of a thing that it's part of the study of being a musician that's not really on your horn, as they say, as the musicians say, or, you know, if you're a singer, this is actually not the singing part, or a guitar player, not practicing with your fingers. The liner notes that are on this record, The Complete Lute Music on Guitar, are written by Clifford F. Gilmore, and I'm looking at them with my 45-year-old eyes, which now have bifocals, and I'm seeing some treasures in here. I'm seeing some really cool things that I had really never pondered before, and so I won't read them verbatim to you, but I will just say that I find it fascinating that here is this very short passage. Clifford Gilmore says, "In the original version of the St. John Passion, a lute along with two viola d'amore provided the accompaniment for the bass arioso, Betracht mein Seel." And so, I pronounced the German wrong, it's Seel, S's are Z's. Anyway, I didn't know that. I didn't know that a lute was involved in the St. John Passion. That's amazing. That's totally cool. Anyway, there are little tidbits about each and every one of the suites that are going on, and it's just extraordinarily, extraordinarily cool reading. So if you can access this, I think it's a lot of fun to read and to check out. We're going to be listening to suite number 3, suite number 4, and then we round out the complete lute works of Johann Sebastian Bach with the Prelude in C minor and Fugue in G minor. And so the BWVs are in this order: 995, 1006A, and then 999, and then 1000. This sides 3 and 4 are totally awesome. I just love this recording so much. I love John Williams' playing. It's awesome. As I alluded on the first record, sides 1 and 2. He just plays so darn fast. He really does. and the music just does its own talking. It's beautiful. It's wonderful. So yeah, we have suite number 3 in A minor. That's what we start off with here. I'll invite you to enjoy it, and we'll talk on the flip side. So enjoy suite number 3 in A minor, BWV 995. Enjoy. Thank you. Well, I hope you really enjoyed that. For side four, we get to hear suite number four, and then the prelude in C minor and fugue in G minor. And I will go ahead and read to you this last little tidbit on the prelude and fugue, because I've often wondered on so many artists' records, these two works are they are paired together, and we'll just listen to this excerpt here. By the way, I will say the suite number four, wow, the playing on this is so cool. It's so amazing. Just the technique involved. And like I alluded on record, or excuse me, on sides one and two, there isn't quite the, you know, the feel and maturity is the wrong word. What I'm trying to get back at is talking about the 1990s recordings of John Williams, where I do find them to be done very, very musically. There is some variances in interpretation techniques and stuff. There's a little bit of that bleeding through on this suite number four. But you know, like my theory said last time, I think that this has to do with recording techniques more than anything. And I only think that because I got to watch a biography of his recording process with a producer, and John Williams was just really in there and talking to the engineer about, you know, levels and this and that. And you know, who knows how compressed the recordings are? I don't know. They don't really sound like what we call now as a dynamic recording, that there's a lot of crescendo, decrescendo, and plus two, he could have been doing the whole sort of 70s interpretation that there weren't the huge crescendo, decrescendo in Baroque music, that sort of a thing. Anyway, let's read what Clifford has to say about the prelude in C minor and fugue in G minor. These are separate works, not originally conceived as a pair, yet they go together quite well. The little gem of a prelude clearly needs something to follow it, since it ends in the key of the dominant, G major, and the G minor fugue just fills the bill. The prelude is preserved only in one contemporary manuscript by J.P. Kellner, which identifies the piece as Prelude in C minor for the Lute by Johann Sebastian Bach. Still, it was published in the Bach Gesellschaft edition and in numerous other editions since then as the third of 12 little preludes for harpsichord. Its gently undulating, basically chordal style suggests the keyboard works of the Cotton years, especially the C major prelude of the Well-Tempered Clavier, Book 1. The fugue is a lute adaptation by Bach himself of the second movement of the first sonata for violin solo BWV 1001. The primary source for this adaptation is a manuscript and lute tablature belonging to Johann Christian Weyroich, which is headed Fuga del Signore Bach. Again, the adaptation seems to be an improvement of the original, with more fugal entries and additional contrapuntal lines which serve to clarify the structure and texture considerably. An even later adaptation of the fugue for organ, the so-called Fiddle Fugue, BWV 539, was very possibly not made by Bach. In any case, it must be regarded as inferior to the lute version as well as the original version. That is a sample of some of the really cool tidbits that one can learn by reading the info on record jackets, on CD liner notes, on cassette liner notes. Now, cassettes, they're pretty small when they do that, but you still can do a lot of reading. So I would encourage you to check that out if you're able to. Thank you again for listening to the Classical Guitar LPs podcast. This has been a joy to work on this John Williams Plays Bach record, The Complete Music on Lute Guitar. This is going to be side four, and this will finish out the double album. Spectacular playing, spectacular music, of course, and it's just sort of a win-win situation. I love the whole record and enjoy. Thanks for listening. Let us know where you're listening to us from. Let me know what service you're using to listen to this podcast. Are you listening to me on Google Podcast? Are you listening to me on iHeartRadio? Where are you listening from? I'd love to hear from you. Check us out on the socials, Instagram.com/PowellGuitar. I'm also on Facebook, Facebook.com/PowellGuitar. We have a YouTube site, whole bunch of things. Check us out. Happy playing and Enjoy the music.
Thank you. Thank you.